So welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and we're using the SUSE Linux Enterprise Server 12, just released this month, October 2014, to demonstrate some of the benefits that you're going to have using Docker. So if we run lsb_release-a, we can see this is in fact SUSE Linux Enterprise Server 12. I'm running as a standard user, so I can use sudo to do anything that I need administratively. And I'm going to use sudo and zipper to install Docker. Docker is part of the standard repositories in Enterprise Linux 12. So, of course, we're going to accept to install. We can see it's not particularly huge that needs to be installed. So 37 plus 6 meg, so sort of 40 meg or so. And once that's complete, let's just clear the screen so we've got a bit of real estate to work with. And we're going to start up those services. So we use systemd in SLES 12. So systemctl enable Docker will enable the auto start of the service. And of course, we'll start the daemon now with systemctl start. So that I might use Docker as a standard user, we can add then a user to the group Docker. So I'll do one more sudo command, sudo user mod minus a to append to the secondary groups. And I'm going to append the Docker group for the user VM user. That's the user account I'm using. Now for this to take effect, I'll just log out and log back in again to be able to pick up the new group ID. And with that process done, we can check this with the ID command. And you can see, in fact, that I do belong to group 485 Docker. If I just run the Docker command by itself, it will list a whole load of subcommands that I can use to manage my images and containers. Docker is a form of virtualization, but is much less memory and resource dependent on other virtualization techniques that use full virtual machines. To show you what we mean, if we use Docker pull and Ubuntu, this will then connect to the online repositories for Docker and will pull down, as we haven't specified a particular version, it will pull down all versions of the Ubuntu in the Docker repositories. Of course, if I was to do this for half a dozen different Ubuntu distributions, you can imagine even in itself that this would take several hours. In effect, this is just going to take a few minutes. Having allowed it to run on my machine, it's taken about 4 minutes to download. And we only need the information just to run the bare necessities. To see how we can use this, we can set up a simple instance. First of all, let's just list the images that we've got, so Docker images, and we can see then that we've got all of the Ubuntu ones. So we've got the name or the repository name and then the tag. So we'll create from an image, we'll create a container. The Linux container we'll have will be for 14.04. So again, we'll clear the screen. We'll check the memory beforehand, and we can see after having just downloaded those, we've got about 68 meg free from my 1.8 meg where we started with, or 1.8 gig rather. So we've got about 68 meg free. And again, we want to see how these containers are going to have little effect on the memory. So to set up a virtual machine, or what we would call container, we use Docker run. We can use minus T so we can assign it a pseudo terminal because we want to run a bash shell. So we can continue reading from standard input. And we're going to use then the image Ubuntu, and we'll have, let's say, 14.04. And then the command that we want to run, so /bin /bash. We'll see later on how we can use Docker files in later videos to automate this process a little bit. But now when we go through and run lsb release minus a, we can see this is now a Ubuntu machine. As we check the free memory, of course, it's using the same hardware as the underlying SUSE machine. And with this one, when we look, it's actually showing a little bit more free memory and still nothing is swapped. So you can see how efficiently we can use this. We've just released some of the file cache buffers from before. So yeah, we see now in effect more free memory. If we want to manage these containers, let's move out to another terminal now. So I'll keep this terminal open. So moving across to a new terminal. And then if we run Docker PS, so we can see then the virtual images or containers that we have running. And then we can use Docker stop. Now, we never assigned a name, so the system generated a name. So I've got to then use the name Thirsty Shockley in this case, so Thirsty underscore Shockley. You can use a minus minus name tag when we run a image to create a container, and that would then assign the name you gave. And then we don't need this anymore, so I'm going to remove the container. I can still create new containers from the image that I have, but I don't need to keep that container as I don't need to run it again. Of course, if you needed to run it again, if it was like a web server or something like that, then we wouldn't need to delete it once we had stopped it. But hopefully this gives you a little bit of an insight into Docker, and we'll have some more Docker videos for you very soon.